to start off, and I've got a couple of different things I'm going to share with you that are a couple different models, but they're all going to tie together. So for instance, to start off, this circle that we see here, not a coincidence that I've got this sort of pretty little circle with the sun at the center. This is actually referred to as a medicine wheel. This is a Native American tradition, the medicine wheel, sort of like the animal, the Lion King, the circle of life. The medicine wheel is a Native American symbol that teaches about life, and more specifically, the cyclical nature of life, or that life is a continuous process of growth and change. And I will tell you that this is one of the central components of all the curriculum I've developed in my addiction treatment work over the last 30 years. I have a whole bunch of material on the medicine wheel, and I relate the recovery process to it. That can be an entire talk in itself, and I'm not going to do that. That'll be another Wednesday Woo talk, going into detail in the medicine wheel, but I want you to be at least familiar with this concept, because it's going to fit into what I'm going to be showing you later in the talk here. But the medicine wheel here, it's the circle of life. It shows that, when I say the cyclical nature, there's four stages of a cycle: a birth, a period of growth, a transition, and then a death. And the nature of a cycle is that the last stage of a cycle leads back into the beginning of the new cycle. And so we're using this medicine wheel. We usually start in the east and we go around the circle in the four directions there: east, south, west, and north tie into those four stages of the cycle. Another concept here is the medicine wheel is a mirror. It shows you yourself. And so when you're on the path and you're connected to life, life is about looking at ourselves, and everything that we experience in life reflects our own experience back, and we're learning something about ourselves by how we see things. That's, again, a deeper topic. We'll get into that in another Wednesday Woo. And as you can see here, I talk about the fact that I use the medicine wheel to relate it to the 12 steps and the addiction recovery process, and I can get pretty deep talking about psychological development and adolescent developmental needs and moving out of childhood and into adulthood and where recovery fits with that. But so just real quickly again, the medicine with the small circle at the center represents the creator, the source of life. We're not going to assign any religious connotations, beliefs, whatever you believe, but maybe we've got to at least acknowledge, that life comes from someplace, that there's some central place that life comes from. And this circle on the outside, the wheel itself, represents the path of life. And everything outside the path is chaos, life without any order, or characterized by denial and delusion. And if you're on the path, you're walking in harmony with all of the universe. If you're off the path, you can't really tell that you're off the path. The next slide here touches on the nature of cycles. And this is the interesting thing, where you can look around you and we see cycles in everything. Life basically occurs in cycles. And so the main cycle we're going to talk about today is the daily cycle. The sun comes up in the east. So that's where we assign beginnings, the beginning of the day. And then it grows, goes down to the south, reaches the highest point at noontime. That's the time of growth, energy, lots of sunlight. We're active during the day. Then it begins to set in the west, and we see the transition from day into night, and we're moving into the darkness. Pay attention to that. We're going to talk about that a lot here today. The move into the darkness, and then ultimately up into the north, the nighttime is the long dark period as we prepare for the cycle, the process to begin again, right? And so, but the neat thing about this is, okay, look at other cycles in our life. There's an annual cycle. spring, the plants start to grow, buds, you know, start to come out of the trees. Summertime, lots of sunlight, full growth, lots of abundance and energy. The plants and the trees are in full bloom. Fall, we have the harvest. The plants begin to turn, the leaves turn. We're preparing to transition from the summer into the winter, and the days are getting shorter, meaning it's getting darker. We're moving into the darkness. Pay attention to that one again. And then we go into the winter, which is associated, identified with a long, dark spell. And it's a death period. The trees, you know, die, or they don't die. They go to dormant, and the plants go to seed, etc. And then the whole process starts over again in the springtime. And we have the rebirth in the spring. So you get where I'm going with this. And we can talk about looking at our life on here. We would associate birth with the east. That's the beginning. Growth would be the childhood, full of energy, the heavy growing period, going through growing pains. And over here in the west would be the adulthood, where we're starting to slow down a little bit. We are starting to reap what we've sown based on how we've conducted ourselves from this childhood into getting to adulthood. Have we been on the path in self-examination? Do we know who we are? That's an aspect of the medicine wheel. We're starting the move into the darkness is the move into looking within and starting to look at myself. And so hopefully by adulthood, I'm in a place where I can answer the question. I have a solid understanding of who I am. That would be a good thing, right? And then we would assign elder with the north time here for this model. And I've got one more slide I'm going to show you here. There's a lot of writing on that slide, right? And like I said, I could give an hour long, I could give a weekend long workshop on the medicine wheel. There's a lot to this. I'm not doing that here today. I'm going to really give a quick synopsis of what all this little type on this slide says here. You see the general idea that we start off on a path. It says birth, pure innocence, spiritually connected. Okay, so wherever life comes from, we come from that source. It invites us to consider the magic of where life comes from. What is this all about? But then our human experience means that we're going to begin traveling the wheel, and by nature of being human, we make mistakes. We are not perfect, and so we're automatically going to stray from the path in a sense. We're going to lose that original innocence or spiritual connection. We're going to get off the path. Now, as you know, and we're raised by caretakers who aren't perfect either, so part of our experience is getting off the path, but we're also growing, and that's the problem. We're starting to grow into a natural process of wanting to establish my own identity and try and figure things out, and it's only natural that we discover things that we're trying to find ourselves, maybe. But what ends up happening is frequently we get off the path and we don't realize that we're off the path, and we're maybe trying things to satisfy needs, unmet needs, that we think is how we're meeting our needs, but they end up becoming self-defeating, and we fall into a addiction, would be a downward spiral of I'm trying to fill some need, it ends up hurting me more, and then I've got all the more reason to meet the need. And so we can get to this point of eventually, if we're lucky, there's an interesting choice, if we're something really intense happens, bad happens, we find ourselves in a situation, maybe sometimes outside forces force us to have to look at ourselves. And then we can make a decision to keep going in the same direction and expect the same results, or we can make the choice to keep moving and face myself. And ultimately, that might be part of the human experience, is to acknowledge my imperfection. Now, addiction might be one of those things, and that's where you can see where I go in terms of tying this into addiction recovery, but the human experience in general. Acknowledge my imperfections and go through a death to my old self, and ultimately we get back and we can start over again. So bottom line is, you can see how that ties into psychological development, specifically from moving from a childlike dependent mindset to an adult mindset. There's some rites of passage, some developmental needs that to make that happen in a healthy way, that is an important part of that process. Okay, that's it on the medicine wheel. That's enough to give us some talking points for where we're gonna go for the rest of this talk.